Hello guys, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Shivam Vijay and today in this video I am going to giving a demonstration on Data Communication Trainer. The Data Communication Trainer is specially designed and manufactured from Tesca Technologies Private Limited for understanding the theoretical as well as the practical knowledge about the different type of communication techniques and protocols. We will study the different protocols like serial and parallel type of protocols, and you will transfer some data from one PC to another PC using this transfer protocol and using the different type of communication links. Like we will do the transfer using directly serial cables through the RS-232 communication with the specified protocols. Also, we will transfer the data using fiber optics communication. We will use the telnet communication for as in RJ45 communication for telephone lines. Also, we'll do the communication even with the wireless setup also. Now, let us, without wasting any more time, we move on to the kit. I will explain you all the components of the trainer kit and we will discuss about what are the included accessories with this and what other requirements you are required to perform all the experiments on this trainer board. And later on, we will also perform some basic experiment in this video. I will explain you how you use the software which is provided for communication that we have provided with the complete setup. So this is the complete front look of the Data Communication Trainer. The order code is 40628. You can find out all the important specification about that, what you can learn from this trainer kit, by visiting our website, which is www.tescaglobal.com. These all are the accessories which comes with the complete setup with the Data Communication Trainer. These are the 25-pin D-type connector for communicating the parallel ports. The parallel ports are provided on the trainer also. So this is for transmitting and this is for receiving end. Both the cables are provided. You can use it anywhere on the ports. Similarly, these are 9-pin serial type connectors for serial communication. These are the D-type cables, male-female cables, so that you can easily connect your PC with the Data Communication Trainer. Similarly, the fiber optics cable, the PMMA cable for the fiber optics communication are provided. These are the slot for receivers. I will explain you also later when we explain the complete kit. The CD material in which all the softwares related to this and drivers for communicating the cables and installing the drivers, driver softwares are also provided. RJ45 connector for the FSK modulator, demodulator communication with this, and some patch codes for communication establishing connection on the trainer board. These are with the 2mm banana circuits, and of course the user manual is also provided in which all the details about the communication protocols, data, how the communication established between with both the two devices, how you can use and develop all the pin details about both the type of connectors, the 25-pin connector, receiving, transmitted connections, how the connections are established, both the pins, all the pin details are, these are the detailed study details are provided in the user manual. You can study it after or before doing the experiments on this trainer board. You will get to knowledge about proper communication of data. Now, talking about the all components and all the blocks on the trainer kit, we'll start with the serial communication block. The serial communication block has the RS-232 COM port, 9-pin and 25-pin. Both the ports are provided for parallel communication using 25-pin LPT port also provided. Wireless communication is provided with the wireless IR transmitter and receiver block with the IR LED module of 920 nanometer and IR module with the inbuilt Schmidt trigger. Baud rate has 2.5 kbps maximum and 20 carrier frequency has 38 kilohertz. Now, for optical transmitter and optical fiber communication, FO transmitter block, the transmitting in point is provided, and this is the SMA connector for communicating and connecting the PMMA cable for fiber optic communication. This is the fiber optic receiver, FO receiver. TTL output will be connected with the RD2 and RD1 communications data input. The output or the receiving end also has the SMA connector, so that data will be passed through the cable or fiber optic cable and connected and received at the receiving end. The transmitting rate is at a 660 nanometer visible rate, and photo detector with the TTL logic output is inbuilt inside that. Baud rate has up to 115 kbps, and plastic fiber step index multimode 1 meter cable is also provided. For modem communication, the FSK modulator block has a mark frequency of 300 kHz, space frequency of 200 kHz. PLL detector is provided for FSK demodulations, also working at 300 kHz with the mark frequency and space frequency at 200 kHz. Baud rate can be established about 19.2 kbps maximum. Twisted pair link RG11 telephone connector is also provided with the kit, and data indication 8-bit received data display is also provided. Onboard switch faults are provided for creating different types of faults in the communication. This is the parallel communication block. Switch 5 is required for bidirectional data buffer, and bidirectional data buffer for input from PC. CN1 is provided for communicating with the CN2. For parallel communication, PC1 will be connected with 25-pin parallel cable, and PC2 for the receiving end, or you can do vice versa, are also provided for 25-pin D-type connector. Similarly, for RS232 trans receiver connection is provided for the 9-pin D-type connector female, and 9-pin D-type connector for trans receiver section at the other end also. Data bits communication inputs are provided on the data field. These are the DTR, DSR, RI and CD call dialing data communication input LEDs are provided. TD1, RTS1, CTS1, RD1, all the data communication input LEDs will be provided, and this will be glowing for when the communication is going on with the transmitter and receiving section. Baud rate selector switch is also provided so that you can easily select any of the baud rate, which are 2400, 4800, 9600, 19200. All the baud rate can be selected with the toggle type of switch. Switch 5 is provided for suitable selecting of baud rate, and it has an onboard power supply of plus 5 volts, minus 12 volts and plus 12 volts, so that you easily connect any of the power requirements of device and module for this complete setup. All the electronics components and ICs are marked on the socket on the front panel, so that easily circuit designs and what are the ICs and what are the integrated circuits are used for the communication purpose. These are also on board connected so that you can easily study complete setup of the data communication trainer. So these are the main components and main design of the complete data communication trainer. Now we'll start doing the practicals one by one, and also we'll get to study and understand the more knowledge about this data communication trainer, how we can use this on the trainer board. Firstly, I will explain you installing the software and what are the PC requirements for this, and how you can communicate the data from this. So when you open the CD folder, you will find a folder like this indicating 40628 on your PC. Open this folder, all the required softwares are provided. So this is the main folder in which the main software of the data communication is installed and provided. This is the ACT14 data communication. If it is in zip file, you can unzip it and then you can use it. Open this. The .NET framework 4.0 is required to install in the PC. It is provided with the software CD. If it is not installed in your PC, you can install it. And this is the software command window. The first extension application file called and named as ACT, which need to be opened for opening the software over here. So this is the main software window for this, for communicating the different type of protocols. Also, you need to connect the parallel port and the serial port to your PC. If both are not provided, as we do not have the facility for providing the parallel and serial port, so we'll use the USB to serial cable. The driver for the basically most known USB to serial cable is provided with this kit. So we'll install this driver. Driver is already installed in our PC, and then we check the cable connected on the device manager. So we'll go to device manager over here. In the COM port selections, we'll see the USB to serial CH340 chip COM4 is provided. So this is connected at COM4. If I disconnect the cable, this COM port will disappear here like this. And if I connect the cable again, it is connected and described and defined in the COM port and LPT ports also. So this is the USB to serial cable that will be extended and connected with the data communication trainer. So these all are the important things that need to be done. The software need to be installed in both the PC. The PC requirement should be about PC hardware should be Celeron P3, P4 and above from that. This is the hardware requirement, and it should have the serial port and parallel port. If it does not have the serial and parallel port, you need to use any adapter, but that might be not working properly in some of cases. If the drivers are faulty, drivers are not properly installed, that might also the causing of issue for not communicating properly. So need to make sure if you are using the adapters for communicating the cables, or see whether it is serial cable or parallel cable, you just install the proper drivers for communicating them for the adapters. Then we have the CD-ROM drive, or you can install it using the online provided software and supports. And operating system need to be Windows 98 XP 2000. And even if I am working on Windows 10 and it is working properly on that, so it will be working on your place also. Make sure both the PCs have same configuration. This should be most need to communicate both the PCs in the easy way. And that is it. You need to do all the things. And if you have the PC which are very old, so that you need to follow the basic software installation program given in the user manual. You need to both PC1 and PC2 should be same configuration like P4 or P3. Then operating system should be same for both PC1 and PC2. That is, we have using Windows 10 in both the PCs. And we need to set the PC motherboard for BIOS setup as follows given in the user manual. Also, you can study it. I will explain you in the video as well. Enter it in the BIOS setup for PC. Set the parallel port in 378 address and set the parallel port in EPP mode. Then we save the BIOS settings. All the things will be nowadays set using the newer software which is provided with this. So we'll go to port setting. The LPT378 is provided. Device ID, you can enter the device ID whatever you want to enter, but make sure do not add the same device ID on both the PCs. Then COM port need to be selected, which is your COM port for the serial communication or whether you are working on the parallel communication. So as we see in the device manager, our serial to USB communicating cable is connected on COM port 4. So we'll select the COM port 4 in the software port setting. So COM port 4 that we have selected. Baud rate, whatever the baud rate you can use, select it, provided on the main board also. So we need to make the baud rate same for communicating with the other PC. Now we move to the second PC, and then we move to the practical how we can perform the serial communication with this. Now moving to first experiment. The experiment number one is about the theoretical study of serial ports. The serial ports has a serial and parallel communication. The serial communication usually requires minimum of 2 wires of data transmitting in one direction, and 1 wire is for data and other wire for the ground. In parallel communication requires as much as wire as the number of bits in a word, for its transmission may be a combination of 4, 8, 16, 32, or 64 bits, etc. Serial pin output of D5, 25 pin and D9 connectors. Pin configurations are also given in the user manual. You can study it about that. Transmitting data abbreviations are provided: TD, RD, RTS, CTS, clear to send, request to send. All the important aspects are given. Pin details of DTE controllers, DB9 male shield type of controllers are provided for transmitting receiving data. These are the different pin details. What are the working of all the pins are given in the user manual. You can study it from this. The detailed study about all the pins are provided in the user manual. So experiment first is generally for the study purpose. So now we move to the second experiment, in which we will establish the data communication. So this is the basic block diagram for study of protocols in serial communication is provided. PC1 is connected with the RS232 cable for transmitting and receiving section, whatever you want to do. If you are using PC1 as transmitter, PC2 will be receiver, and if you are using PC1 as a receiver, PC2 will be transmitter for this. So this will be connected with the COM port selection on the data communication trainer. Then we will connect TD1 and RD2 port with the patch ports, similarly RD1 with the TD2 port. Switch 4, which are the setting required, need to be known condition, CTS2 and RTS2. These are the hardware and software communicating signals. We will study it about also in the video further. COM port 2 will be connected on the transmitting end from the other PC, and that is how we need to build up the block setup. We'll study it practically also. Moving to the practical details, these are the basic theories in which the communication establishing and the different topologies are explained, so that you can study it. The signal electrical characteristics are also provided. Complete detail about the basic serial communication is provided. And now for establishing a communication and transmitting a data, we will follow the procedure. So we'll connect the power supply with the proper polarity on the kit. Then we use the connection settings for figure 2.1 as we see earlier, and we'll connect 9-pin D-type connector cable with PC1 COM port and to CN3 COM port on the trainer, and CN4 will be connected with the second PC. Then we connect TD1 post to RD2 post as described in the figure also, and then we connect RD1 with the TD2 post. Then we keep the switch setting as far as described in the figure. Then we switch on the power supply of trainer board. We'll run the software and establish the communication between both of the two PC. We'll transfer the data using different protocols, X modem, Y modem, different type of protocol provided in the software, and then that we will study the complete communication using serial communicating protocol. So now we move to the connections on the trainer board. So for communicating the connector CN3 and CN4 with the PC, I am using this USB to serial port. Drivers are already installed in the PC. A driver software is also provided if you have the USB to serial communication cable or adapter like this, with working on CH340 chip. A driver will work on that as well. And we'll connect the 9-pin D-type connector cable with the communicating port using this serial to USB connector, and this USB slot will be connected on our USB slot on PC. So this is how we both the PC will be connected on the trainer. So we'll connect the USB on the PC, and the other end of this cable will be connected on the CN3 connector for RS232 transmitting and receiving. As the similar way, we'll connect the cable on the other hand, and this end of this cable will again connected with the RS232 communicating cable for the other PC as well, and this USB slot will be connected with the USB slot in the PC. After connecting both the cables, make sure both the cables are properly installed and showing their COM ports on the PC, both the PC. Now, using the page course, we'll connect TD1 post with the RD2 post, and RD1 post with TD2 post. So this is the basic circuit for communicating both the transmitting and receiving. The TD1 and RD2 are for the data communication and transmitting, and the RD1 and RD2 is provided for the ground. So both the signals, as we study in the basics of this first practical, in which theoretical details about provided for RS232 communicating for serial, in which we have studied that we require two wires generally for communicating data from serial communication. So these are the basically two wires for communicating the data, and these are different data bits and LEDs that will be glowing when we use and communicating the transfer. Now we'll turn on the trainer kit, and as the trainer kit is turned on, here you can see the data bits are generating and showing that the data is can be transferred on the 8-bit data, and this is the baud rate selecting switch. So right now baud rate is 9600. The LED will shuffle to the different baud rates when you press the switch. This is now 2400, so we'll select this to 9600, which is a standard baud rate. You can do perform practical on the different baud rates as well. So now we come to first PC. So in which we have to set the port settings, then we made this PC as a transmitter for transmitting the data. Now we'll first select the port setting in this. I have opened the ACT14 data communication software as we described earlier. Now go select the port setting tab over here, in which the port setting is described. LPT port LPT1 and LPT2 port address 378 need to be constant for all the practicals. When you do the parallel practicals, parallel communication, this need to be also same. Now we'll select the device ID. So we'll provide device ID 1 for the PC1, and COM port, which is at which our USB to serial cable is connected, need to be selected as COM port 4. So COM port 4, USB to serial connected at the COM port 4. So we'll select the COM port 4 in the port setting. So COM port 4 is selected over here. Now we select the baud rate from different baud rates provided. We'll select 9600, which is a standard baud rate for all type of communication. Data bits need not to be changed, which is unchangeable. Parity, you can change it even odd or none. So we'll provide none parity for this. Stop bits need to be 1, and this is unchangeable for this. And press OK. So these are the port settings that has been done. We need to do same port setting with the other device ID on the second PC as well. Now we go to protocols, in which we can configure the PC as a transmitter mode or as a receiver mode as well. So we'll first communicating and establishing this transmitter and this first PC as a transmitter mode, and here we have selected serial port communication for the communication, as we have using the serial ports and serial cable for the data communication trainer. Now we'll select the protocol, which is X modem protocol, at which we have to select the and transfer the file. You can select on both of the any of them, but it depends on the PC configuration. Sometimes it creates some errors on the Z modem protocol as well. So we'll select X modem for priority. Here, real time speed and slow speed of transmission, that is selectable from both of them. Analysis tab is also provided. So these are some other analysis for time to transfer in milliseconds is provided, number of packets that is transferred from the files, errors 0. These are the different transmitting section files protocol that is already done from this system as well. So this will be in the communication analysis tab. Now here is a, from your, you can select any file in your PC from selecting this, and these are the file details that will be automatically displayed when you select any file. So we'll select a file. This is a Word file over here. This is a test file for PC one that I have created over here, and I will open this file to show you what is containing. So this is a file in which I will type the message "Hello from Tesca Technologies." This is a test file to transfer, which is described in this tab. Now we'll select this file, and as I select, the number of packets will be displayed on this blank area. So the complete number of packets is 72 and file size is 9138 for this in KB, sorry, in bytes, and we can transfer up to 10 kilobytes of file from this. So I have created around maximum or almost around 10 kilobyte files from this transferring protocol. These are the data transfer and data packets, and this is it from this transmitter mode. We press the start file transmission once we configure the other PC as a receiver. This is our PC2, in which we have to first define the port settings. COM port 3, which is at which the RS232 to USB connector is connected. Device ID, we have provided device ID 2 for this as well. LPT and 7378 LPT port address will be remain same for condition. Baud rate that need to be select, it is 9600. This should be same as we select in the first PC. Data bits is 8, we cannot change it. Parity should be none as we selected in the first PC, and stop bit should be 1. So these are the port settings. This need to be done. Now we go to protocols, and now we'll make this PC and configure this as a receiver. So receiver mode here we have selected over here, and press serial and the protocol same as first PC. So this is X modem that we are selecting. Press set over here, and this is it, nothing need to done. When we press the start file transmission from the first PC, then we press the receive file transmission. The file will be start transferring in packets. The packets will be showing on this blank screen. All the details also on showing in this lower message window. And then as the complete transfer done, this will ask you to save the file and providing it a name. And that's how your file transfer will be completed using the serial port communication. Now, before transmitting data from one PC to other, make sure the baud rate should be at 9600 that we have selected in the data communication trainer, as we have selected baud rate in both the PCs 9600. So baud rate need to be same in all the three places for communicating the data. Now we'll press the start file transmission from over here. Packets are created. Now we'll press the receive file transmission, and all the data packets one by one starts transmitting. Also, you can observe the LEDs are blinking on the trainer as well, and as the data transfer is completed, this will ask you to save the file with any name. So we'll save the file in the received PC, providing a name, test received serial communication. So this is our first file that we are providing in name. We can provide the extension also. So we'll providing ODT extension, so that file will be directly open in OpenOffice or OpenOffice Word, and we'll press enter for saving the file. Now we come to close to second PC and see what is the file which is transferred. Now on the receiver PC, we'll find the file here. The file is saved at this location in the desktop, and this is the test receive serial file that we have created. Now we'll open this and see here, "Hello from Tesca Technologies, this is the test file for transfer. Same message and same file is received on the receiving section as well. So this is how we create and perform the serial communication. Now similarly, we'll do some more communications with the different links as well on the data communication trainer. Now in the next experiment, experiment number 3, we can study the flow controls in the serial communication. The flow control generally based in two types, the X on X off type, and the other one is RTS CTS hardware flow control. Theory about both the type of flow controls are given in the user manual. You can study it properly, and this is the procedure for both the types of procedure for communicating and transferring the device. This is a basic hyperterminal method for hardware and RTS CTS control, both type of control, X on X off and hardware control. So this is the same procedure as we followed in the first practical for different communicating protocols with the hyperterminal. Hyperterminal is an old-fashioned way to transmitting the file from one to another. I will explain you also the hyperterminal, how to use this using the data communication trainer. The hyperterminal is also provided in the software CD. So you can use the hyperterminal for transmitting the data from one to another one. And if you are using a XP, Windows XP configured PC, the hyperterminal must have installed in that already. And if it is not, you can install it using through the settings from the control panel as well. Now we'll open the hyperterminal. We'll provide any name for the connection. So we'll provide PC1 for this and press OK. Now we need to connect the modem using COM port. The COM port should be same as we are selecting in the COM port selection of the RS-232 USB communicating cable, serial to USB cable, which is connected at COM port 4. So we'll press OK. Now we have to provide the port settings and properties. So we'll select port settings at 9600. Data bits, you can select at any different bits, but make sure you select port settings for both the PCs is same. Now this is the flow control over here. There are three type of flow controls, X on, X off, hardware and none. So we'll first select X on, X off and press apply. Press OK. Here this is the hyperterminal is connected to the first port of our PC. Now we'll select a file from transfer end over here. So we'll send a file from selecting it from transfer. You can select different type of protocols, 1K, Kermit, X modem, Y modem, Y modem, G, Z modem with crash recovery. So we'll selecting the Z modem with crash recovery, which is default protocol for this. And now we'll select browser file. The file can be any for transmitting. So we'll selecting the same file, test file for PC1 for transmitting over here. As we press send, the further process will be starts, but before we will go to second PC and see some same procedure for hyperterminal. So as you open the CD folder in the second PC as well, this will, here you will find hyperterminal also. Open the hyperterminal, provide a connection name PC2, let us say for this, and press OK. Here we'll select the COM port at which our USB to serial communication cable is connected. So we'll select COM3. Same port settings need to be done for this. Parity none, stop bits none, and flow control X on X off. So we'll doing first transmitting on X off for the first flow control. Press apply and press OK. Here the second PC is also connected. Now we're ready to receive the files from the transfer section. Press receive file and press receive when you press the send file from the first PC. Now let us take a look on trainer board. Over here you can see both the LEDs for DTE and DSP, DSR are in on mode, and this is at the RTS 1, transmitting 1 is on mode continuously, and this is RTS 2, the transmitting 2 receiving transmitting section is continuously on. So that is indicating that both the ports are connected to PC. Right now we have established a connection from both the sides, and baud rate as we have selected 9600 from the switch over here. Make sure all the ports at the switch port section should be in off condition for this practical. And for setting the RTS and CTS from this, make sure you turn off the switch 4 for the first state, and now we'll transfer the file from first PC to second PC and let us see what is the effect of this. So from the transmitting section we'll press send, and other end is starts receiving the file automatically because both are connected, and in some time complete file is transferred and received on the receiving end. Now we go to second PC and see how the file is received. Now in the receiving PC, we'll close the receiving section, and here the file is received in the hyperterminal block over here. We'll open this. This is the same file, hello from Tesca Technologies, test file is to transfer. So that's how we transfer the file using different flow controls. Now we transfer the file from the PC2. This time we'll make this as a transmitter. We'll browse the file, and this is the readme file from the folder that will be transferred from this. But this time we'll change the flow control connection, of course, for this. Disconnect, over here you can see the connection is disconnected. We'll change the properties, go to configuration, and over here we select flow control as hardware. Press apply, press OK, and again connect. And now we'll send the file from here. So this is ready for sending. Now we move to the second PC and change the protocol and properties for port setting as well. Similarly, at the first PC, we again disconnect the connections and change the properties and flow control as hardware. Apply this, OK, and press OK again and connect it. Now we make this PC as a receiver as we are sending file from the PC2, and press receive when the file starts receiving. Over here you can see the file is not receiving till we do not press the send from the first PC. And now I will press send from first PC and let us see what is the effect. Here file is transferred. Because the file is very short in length, pretty quickly transferred, and we check the file from the PC1 where at which the file is received. Now for checking the file, we'll minimize the window and here the readme file is received on this section. So this is how we transfer the files using different types of flow controls. Now in the experiment number 4, which is our next experiment, the study of protocols in data communication is provided. There are different types of protocols, and objectives for this experiment: stop and wait, ARQ, go back, and selective repeat, and protocols used in hyperterminal. All the detailed study theoretical details are given in this practical. You can study all the protocols and theory about different types of data communication protocols, all the commands, all the main details and different parameters of this protocol sections are given. So this is complete study based protocol, study based practical that can be studied in this user manual. Now moving to experiment number 5, which is data communication using fiber optics communication. The block diagram is given in the user manual of experiment number 5. Same first PC is connected on CN3 using RS232 transceiver connector. TD1 will be connected with TX in the FO transmitter section, and FO transmitter will be connected with FO receiver using the fiber optic cable provided with the kit. At the other end, TTL output will connected with the RD2 inputs, and this will connected with the CN4 and COM port 2 of the PC2, and fault switches should be in off condition in this case, and all the faults at the switch 4 should be in on condition. So these are all the required connections. RD1 will be connected with TD2 also for providing the ground signal. And now we'll follow the procedure as given in the user manual, and then we transfer the file using fiber optics communication with this path. Now we'll do the connection setup. First, make sure the four switches of RXTX is in the on condition, both the switches, as we on both the lights or LEDs are indicating it. Now we'll connect the TD1, which is connected with the CN3 first port of the PC1, with the TX in at the fiber optics transmitter. The light also showing over here, this is the laser communication light. Now we'll use the fiber optic cable which is provided with the kit. Carefully connect the SMA connector and tight it properly on this block, and over here you can see the light is coming out from the cable, and you'll connect it on the receiver section. Properly tight the SMA connector, and now using a patch code we'll connect the TTL output terminal with the RD2, and using a patch code we'll connect RD1 with the TD2. These all are described in the diagram also, and we have set up the fiber optic communication link between both the two PCs. Now we'll transfer the file using the same communication. Now we'll again open the software for the data communication over here. Port settings will remain same as per the serial. You can change the baud rate if you want to, and we'll use the transmitter mode, same X modem that we need to select in protocol. Select browse file. This time we'll select another file that I've created some different files over here. So test file for FO communication, fiber optic communication, we'll open this. The message is, this is the test file for transferring using FO communication, and the message is entered over here. So we'll open this. Similar 72 packets this time now created, 73 from 0 to 72. Now we go to receiving PC and do the all settings for receiving as well. Here again we'll open the software for this. Port setting same as the serial port, and in the receiver mode we'll make this serial port configuration set and ready for receiving all the files. Here now we are ready to receive the file from transfer the file from one PC to another. As we press start from the start PC, and now we'll press receive from the receiving PC, and your transmission from one end to another PC is going on with the fiber optics link. You can also observe LEDs are blinking on the kit. Now we have received the file. Now we have to enter the name of the file, and then we check the file should be same as what we have transferred from the first PC. So here this is our receiving end PC. Now we have to enter the name of the file, which is test receive for FO transfer, that we are going to giving the name for this, and press enter for saving it. Now we go to the menu and check the file that is saved in the test receive for transfer format. for opening this, I will changing the extension. Of this file so that we can open it in OpenOffice and read it. Here the file has containing the same information, which is hello from Tesca Technologies test. This is the test file for transferring using FO communication. So we have received the file successfully using the fiber optics transmission. Now moving to next experiment, in which we are going to see the modem communication. For this we are using the telephone link with RJ45 connector provided, and all the details and block diagrams is similar as per the other practicals. Just need to make some changes on the communication path. The modem communication study details in theory is given about FSK modem, FSK modulation, FSK demodulation, modem interfacing using RS-232, modem interconnection. All the details about different type of modem communications are given. Now you can study it from the user manual. Now we'll do the practical, keeping all the switch faults in the off position. First we'll do the procedure for FSK modem. We'll connect the 9-pin D-type connector cable between PC1 and COM. PC1 communication port to CN3. Similarly, D-type 9-pin connector cable PC2 common port to CN4, and then we connect power supply, connect TD1 post in to the FSK modulator and out post to the demodulator with the RD2, and we'll connect telephone link between RJ11 provided and connect RD1 TD2 for the ground, and then we set the switch port as described in the diagram, block diagram, and then we'll transfer some files using this modem transfer protocol. Now on the kit we'll connect TD1 using patch codes to the input of FSK modulator, and output of the FSK demodulator will be connected with the RD2. Now we'll connect the telephone link RJ11 cable with CN5 to CN6. So this is the telephone link cable that is provided with the kit. Carefully connect the connector. Over here we have connected both the cables. Now connect RD1 with TD2 using a patch code. So these are the connections that need to be done on the kit. Now similar process need to be followed for transmitting the file from one PC to another. Similarly, we'll set the port setting as per the requirement, 9600 baud rate, parity none, and in protocol we'll make it transmitter. X modem mode, browse the file. Here we have created a file RJ11 communication. I will open the file. Let us see the message in that. Hello from Tesca Technology, this is the file for transfer from RJ11 telephone cable communication. So this is for modem communication. So we have created file and select the file. Packets are created over here. We'll start file transmission. Before that we'll make the receiver on the other PC. Now for making it receiver, same port setting need to be done. We'll select, and now in the protocol we'll make this receiver, select it as a receiver and X modem mode, set it. Now we're ready to transfer the files using RJ11 cable. So now we will press sending and receiving from both the PCs. So we'll press start file transmission and receive file transmission. So sending and receiving will be continuously done. LED blinking on the kit you can also observe. while data is transferring. Here, after completing the data transfer, we need to give it name of the received file. So I have created the name for receiving file. Also, we'll give the extension to it to open it in OpenOffice to save the file. And now we'll open the file. In our PC. Here in the hyperterminal folder, file is saved as RJ11 communication that we have given the name. Now I'll open it and see what is data in it. The data is same. Hello from Tesca Technologies. This is a test file to transfer RJ11 communication. So that is how we communicate and transfer a file from one PC to another PC using the modem communication. So this is how you can perform different type of communication of data. Data transfer is done using serial communication with the different type of links. We have explained the fiber optics link, RJ11 link in this video. Also the serial communication directly also explained in this video. So similarly, as I explained in this video, you can do all your experiments given in the user manual, follow it. All the details of different type of communication protocols are given in that. So you can study the data communication deeply with the help of user manual and with the software and the process of communicating the data and transferring the data as explained in this video as well as with the kit. Experiments based on the parallel communication does not cover in this video, as we do not have the availability of the parallel port in both the PCs, and there is no alternate solution also available so that we can perform the parallel port. But when you get the kit and you got the complete information in the user manual, so that you can easily perform the parallel port application, parallel port communication with the data communication trainer. Cables are provided with the kit so that you can easily connect the kit with your both PCs. You can also subscribe our channel, which is Tesca Tech on YouTube. There are a lot of video uploaded with the different type of educational trainer with the detailed practical explanations, so that you can clear your different interesting topics of your education sectors. And also, don't forget to press the bell button, so whenever we upload our new video with a new trainer explaining a new technology, you will be notified about that as well. Till then, thank you for watching this video, and we will meet in the next video very soon.